For getting up on this cold, blustery morning. It really doesn't feel like a student of the month in February unless we have a little snow and ice to get our in the morning. So thank you for braving it. There's no better way to start a February morning. I'd like to welcome you all to the student of the month breakfast. My name is Kelly Dastel, and I'm the assistant principal for the senior class this year, the class of 2020. It's always a pleasure to be hosting this event because we get a chance to honor students here at LT. And we know how big this place can be sometimes. It's events like this that really make it feel smaller and make it feel like a much more warming, welcoming environment. The students being honored here today will be presented by their nominating teachers, and the teachers will share with you why they've been nominated. Please realize some of our teachers might have a first hour class, so if they try to sneak out the back, it's not because they don't want to be here. They have students that are waiting on them. And students, just to help us out with things, there is an X on the floor here if you can stand there. That way we are sure you're in the shot for LTTV, and Ms. Faye doesn't have to do all kinds of creative editing to make sure that she gets you into that. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome up our first presenter this morning. If I could welcome up Ms. Connie Lida, who's going to be telling us a little bit about Kayla Baker. Ms. Lida.
There. That's fantastic. Thanks for that, X, Ms. Faye. That's wonderful. So I'm actually representing my invisible twin here, John Music, and myself. So if you can just picture him there. We've known this girl since her freshman year because she's been in choir for that long. How many years in band? I meant to put that into our conversation.
I've done all four with the color guard.
As well. Her sweet voice has grown beautifully over the course of her 4 years. And between that and her fine ear and sight reading skill, Kayla is a reliable leader in our soprano section of varsity choir. There are two other areas in which she makes an irreplaceable difference in choir. The first is service. Faithfully, Kayla has been present for years during the most arduous setups for various choir activities and fundraisers, and she has always been willing and able to do the least desirable jobs. She is famous for the hanging of little Italian lights in the chorale, but she does much more than that. She is there at the beginning of the setup and stays through the event through takedown cleanup, performing duties she signed up to do and filling in wherever someone is most needed during the time she hasn't signed up. She has a strong and selfless work ethic. She's delightfully pragmatic, so organization and efficiency are second nature to her, but there isn't a bossy bone in her body. The second attribute she shares so freely is her positivity, and kind of with that is her humility. Combine these with her incredible work ethic, and you get this lovely young lady who chuckles all the way through fixing the mess left by people manning the baked goods table, completely shrugs off credit for how much of our success is due to her. I was hoping that we'd get a chuckle in there somewhere, and I could say just like that. There it is. Okay. Thank you. Good job. Right on cue. She is mature and attentive, but always makes the room lighter during rehearsal. Mr. Music and I agree that Kayla is a treasure and a force, and the whole LT Choral program is stronger because of this young lady, Kayla Baker.
I know Mr. Music, the music teacher, would appreciate everything that you said, Ms. Lida.
He's teaching edibles right now.
Yes, so. Yes. So you did an excellent job representing him as well. Thank you so much. Our next presenter this morning, I'd like to welcome up from our math department, Mr. Danny Berg. Mr. Berg.
Hello. Good morning. My name is Dan Berg. I'm a teacher here at North. I teach in the math department, and I had the pleasure of nominating Alan Garcia as our student of the month for math. I unfortunately only had Alan for one semester. I wish I had him for another one, but he's now moved on to a different class. But we had some great times in math for a semester, and Alan was, he achieved at a very high academic level, but that's really not why I nominated him this semester. I nominated him because of his interaction with his peers. Alan would tend to finish our class assignments way shorter than I expected, but rather than sitting back and relaxing, he'd seek out students that really needed some help. So he'd start with his group, he'd look if any students needed help there, and then he'd get up and almost act as a second teacher in the room, which I really, really appreciated. And it's great to see a student take initiative and help towards a student-centered environment. And like I said, Alan has now moved on to a different class, but I know he's continuing to help his teacher out, and he's continuing to help his classmates out, and I'm sure they appreciate it just as much as I did. So thank you, Alan, and thank you. There you go, please.
Our next presenter this morning could not just decide on one student, but needed to settle on two. I'd like to welcome up from our art department, Mr. Matt Brode. Mr. Brode.
Hey, good morning. My name is Matt Brode, and I'm joined up here this morning by Annette and Nora. And it really is my pleasure and my privilege to recognize them as the North Campus January Students of the Month in the Art Department. I've worked with them in ceramics both over a number of years. And as a North Campus teacher, I think that this can be a bittersweet time of year as kids finalize their plans for next year. And youngsters are talking about what colleges they're going to. It does become kind of very real, that relationships and learning partnerships that we've enjoyed and celebrated and really rejoiced in for the past couple of years are gonna come to an end soon. So I wanted to take this last opportunity to really publicly acknowledge just how much you two have meant to me over the years at LT. So I'm gonna start by celebrating Annette. I have known Annette for 3 years now. I had some prepared comments here, but I just changed my prescription on my glasses. So I'm gonna try to get through this. I wrote this a week ago. I have known Annette for 3 years now. Annette is a quiet, gentle, soft-spoken young lady that navigates learning with an unassuming confidence. She is thoughtful and reflective and models strength and courage not only through the bold risks that she takes with her creativity, but more importantly, by consistently making the right choices. Her calming presence creates space for others to find time in the middle of the day to enjoy one another's company. Her hand reaches out to help, and her words of encouragement help shape others' progress. She offers respect and inclusivity. When I see Annette, her sweet smile lets me know that all is well, and that it indeed is going to be a great day. I wish Annette much success next year and beyond. I thank you for the many positive memories that you will leave me with, and I will surely miss you. My own journey would not have been complete without you. Congratulations. This is for you. Thank you. Nora, I first met Nora at South Campus 4 years ago, and I have genuinely enjoyed watching her grow as an athlete, as an artist, and as an LT learner. I have always appreciated Nora's enthusiasm for new challenges, her quest for excellence, and her determination for achieving success. As an instructor, I have watched this dynamic permeate the classroom and saw how Nora connects with those around her and brings them along for the ride with her. Nora's positive spirit brightens our pathway and illuminates our way forward, showing how we can focus on team spirit while pursuing individual goals. Nora's Collaborative consciousness makes her a natural leader in the classroom and on a playing field and amongst colleagues and classmates alike. Nora celebrates the learning experience in all that she says and all that she does. And I know that our time together has shaped my own personal growth and professional growth at Lyons Township. Thank you, Nora. Thank you, Nora, for being such a beacon of optimism, for embodying the spirit of education, and for using your many gifts to bring us closer together. I wish you continued success. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, Mr. Broad, you took my sheet. I don't know who's next.
That's okay.
After those fine words. Our next presenters, I'd like to welcome up this morning, are from our language arts and our social studies department, from our American Studies class, Ms. Gretchen Poulette and Ms. Jennifer Setsky.
I always have to move it down, I don't know why. Good morning. Gretchen and I are here representing our American Studies class. It's a combined English, American Literature, and U.S. History. And we are thrilled to be able to nominate Sasha Kruger this year, this month, I should say. I'm the lucky one because I've known Sasha for 2 years. She was in my civics class at South Campus last year. And what struck me last year was Sasha's maturity. She, in discussions, just could handle things in a different level than her peers, and was a great group leader in a pretty much discussion-led class. So when I saw her name on my roster this year, I was thrilled again. And what I really noticed for this month and why we both thought we would nominate her is I believe there are two things you need to be successful in life. One is a good work ethic, and the other is to be kind. And Sasha embodies both. We are amazed by her strong work ethic in both of our disciplines, but her kindness is what really endears her to us. She reaches out to those who need help, intrinsically motivated. We don't tell her to do so, she does it on her own. And for that, in a very big class like ours, we are extremely thankful. Okay. I'll let Gretchen speak too.
And I'll just add a little bit as well. I need to move it up. So the combined class is two class periods, and we have her first and second. And you can imagine, first period is a little rough sometimes, but often Sasha comes in caffeinated, which is good. But she's a little on the quiet side, but that also could be because it's first period. But as Jennifer mentioned, the quietness is not from shyness necessarily. It's because I think she's sort of digesting and thinking about what she's going to present, you know, rather than blurting things out, which is also a sign of her maturity. She listens well, she follows directions. We do a lot of experimenting in English with our writing and writing techniques, and she embraces those opportunities and really strives to better herself. And that is really nice to see when she's not just tuning me out like some students do, but really trying to better herself as a writer and as a person. The most outstanding characteristic that Sasha possesses, though, is her thoughtfulness, to echo what Jennifer said. She has a sense of compassion that's hard to find in teenagers nowadays. She always chats with other students, checks on them to see how they're doing. She's especially helpful if a student's been absent or a student is struggling. Again, she seeks them out and really lends them a hand, and I think that is something to be commended for. And although these actions may seem minor and sort of not academic related, it's really adding to the class environment, and we really want to recognize what a thoughtful and considerate and hardworking young woman Sasha is. So, congratulations.
Congratulations, Sasha. Our next presenter this morning, I'd like to welcome from our Family and Consumer Science Department, Ms. Brianna Basic. Ms. Basic.
Good morning, I'm Brianna Basic, and I'm nominating Christian from the Family and Consumer Science Department. So I had the pleasure of having Christian both last semester and this semester. He took Child Development 1 last semester, and now he decided to continue on with Child Development 2 this semester. So a characteristic I noticed about Christian right from the start of the year was his enthusiasm. Christian would come to class every day just with a big smile on his face and just an eagerness to learn and just take on whatever day activity there was. Christian takes pride in his work, and this became more and more evident as the entire semester progressed. And then as soon as we began our preschool lab is when Christian's leadership qualities really started to emerge and develop. Christian was always one of the first students into class every day, and every day without even like any prodding from me, he would pick up and kind of start the day's activities. The activities consisted of turning the cubby lights on for our preschoolers, opening the doors, grabbing the clipboard, the pen, like getting everything ready to go for when our preschoolers walked in the room. So I really appreciated not having to ask Christian, not having to have any other students do it. Christian just did it without being asked. So that was really, really appreciated. And then another reason why I chose Christian as Student of the Month is because of his dedication to producing high quality work. Throughout the entire preschool lab, he always was so dedicated to making sure his lessons were perfect, high quality, and were going to be really beneficial to the preschoolers. An example of this was coming in multiple times outside of class to make sure his bulletin board was rock star job. And then when developing lesson plans for the preschoolers, Christian always, like I said, strive for high quality work. He had high expectations for himself. He put in a ton of effort and consistently sought feedback from me. How can I improve my lessons for next time? Is this lesson going to be great? And again, I appreciated that. And I think as a result, you produced some really amazing lessons that the preschoolers really loved. So great job. So again, I'm glad that Christian is taking Child Development 2 this semester. I'm looking forward to continuing to see his enthusiasm every day and to see those leadership qualities continue to develop. Great job, Christian.
Congratulations. Our next presenter this morning from our science department, I'd like to welcome up Mr. Jim Mishar. Mr. Mishar.
All right, good morning. It's my pleasure to nominate Katie G for Student of the Month in Science. I'm gonna read what I wrote, and I might add a few things at the end here. So Katie's been a great student and a wonderful presence in our physics classroom this year. Katie is a hard worker, and she is absolutely thorough in completing her assignments and preparing for exams. She can always be counted on to not only have her work done, but to help her classmates when they struggle. And I'll add to that, physics can be hard, right? Nothing about it sounds real easy. So I, as a teacher, know my colleagues feel the same way. We appreciate when students help each other. You know, and Katie definitely does that in the classroom and is a good example for that. Katie has questions regarding the material, she's always willing to ask and share the information with her classmates. During laboratory experiments, Katie takes charge and helps her classmates understand what they're seeing. And by the way, I'll mention that too. In science, especially physics, we do a lot of labs, and we hope and expect our students to be able to accomplish a lab and take something out of it. And Katie's exceptionally good at doing that. And as I said, helping her classmates kind of understand the material. In addition to being an excellent student, Katie possesses a wonderful demeanor. She is friendly and quick to smile, and she gets along very well with her classmates. Katie sets an outstanding example for her classmates, and her presence makes our classroom a better place. Katie, I appreciate your presence so very much.
Congratulations, Katie. Our next presenter this morning is from our Business Education Department. I'd like to welcome up Ms. Walker, who again could not just come up with one, but had to have two, and that's okay.
Marketing, you have to have visuals. Good morning. It is my pleasure to introduce Avery and Ellie as the Business Education Students of the Month. I was lucky enough to have Avery and Ellie in my marketing classes this fall. They were partners for a campaign pitch project. Students take a generic product and then manipulate it to have a uniqueness and then brand it. They start with developing a creative brief and design a tagline, slogan, logo, packaging, and promotional advertisements. We are fortunate that we have professional marketers come in and present. They assist the students in their briefs and finally hear their campaign pitches at the end of the semester. Avery and Ellie selected acne cleanser as their product. As they researched and analyzed the data from their survey, a problem was identified, and then they got down to work. First, their company was born, Glow. Next, they came up with the tagline, Wash Your Troubles Away. Their slogan for their campaign was Confidence with Clarity. Avery and Ellie had a great work ethic. They communicated with each other and relied on each other's strengths and took lead roles in various areas. I wish all my groups would have worked as cohesively as Avery and Ellie and had as much fun. To say the least, they found their groove. I want to share some of the feedback that they received from the marketers on pitch day. Minimizes plastic footprints. Simple but powerful slogan. Physical change gains emotional benefit. Excellent TV spot using black and white turning into color. Great social media insights. Problem, solution. Thought process was fantastic. Email catchy started, hey beautiful. Lastly, the girls received several accolades, including best slogan, confidence with clarity, best display, as you're seeing here, best social media, received honorable mention for their print ad, and acknowledged for their public relations connection to body dysmorphic disorder. They donated a percentage of their revenue. And you guessed it, first place overall campaign pitch. I love watching the students start from start to finish, at the end seeing their absolute amazement at what they were able to create. Needless to say, these two young ladies absolutely amazed me. Congratulations.
To go into marketing in college. Absolutely, they are well on their way. Our next presenter this morning from our Fine Arts Department, I'd like to welcome up with Ms. Anuj Kolathu, who's gonna be presenting a student from her Spanish 3 class.
This is going to seem like a very random way to start, but for as long as I can remember, my dad has said he wishes he could have 100 daughters like me, which is a line that comes to mind when I get a student like Hannah. Modified, obviously. I wish I could have 100 students like her. From the first day of school, she has been a joy to have in class. She just comes in with positive vibes, positive attitude. Look, you can see a smile on her face, like laughing, ready to go, a willingness to work hard. Try anything. The type of kid where if I said, hop on one foot and do the alphabet backwards in Spanish, she would be like, okay, is there a time limit or should I just, you know, like willing to try anything. She truly seems like she wants to be in class. The type of student that makes a class feel more like a home just by her attitude, her what she says, the way she gets along with everybody. Academically, her hard work has paid off. Can I share the thing about the S?
Yeah.
She used to use the word S, which means is, like he is, she is, it is, in a sentence where it didn't belong. She would use it like 5 times in a sentence, and she stopped doing that. I'm just very proud of that. She has taken her Spanish outside of our 4 walls. She has binge-watched the soap opera that we watch on Fridays. Did you finish it?
No.
But... there are so many episodes. She kindly never spoils it for anybody. And moreover, she watches the episode that she's already seen attentively as if she has never seen it before. Like I would have never guessed that she has watched way more episodes than we have. And so I really appreciate everything about Hannah. Hannah, I want you to know that I appreciate you and all of the positivity you bring to our class. Keep it up and know that your teachers are lucky to have you as a student. Here we go. Here's your certificate.
Our final presenter this morning, I'd like to welcome up from our physical welfare department, Ms. Susie Murphy. Ms. Murphy.
Good morning. This morning, I'd like to present to you Matt Urban as our student of the month in physical welfare, specifically scuba diving class. Some people say I do have a great job working at LT. I know that because I'm an alumni, but it's just even a little bit more special when you get to scuba dive, and then when you get to scuba dive with kids like this. I had Matt as a junior and as a senior, and you heard, we have amazing kids at LT, and you know that you live in this community where I grew up. However, when they come to you and they're like, can you write a letter of recommendation for me? And you're like, yes, I have 100 of you, but how do I make it special for you? And with Matt, he made that so simple. Matt has shined in a class where we had some struggles. The first thing he did as a scuba two was challenge his own peers that were also taking the class. It's a teacher's dream when you don't just say, you're just not cutting it. I need you to step up. When your peer, they do that for their peers. And that's something Matt did. He'd come in prepared. He'd come in with things done. And he'd look at his buddies that were trying to help be my leaders. He'd say, you guys just don't have it yet. Let's go. Step it up. I know you can handle this. Put in the effort. And Matt did that often for me with our Scuba 2 students. Most importantly, when you go to kindness and instruction, Matt had that with our Scuba 1 students. We spend 10 weeks in the pool every day. The students are in the pool every day. The teacher is in the pool every day. And we have a lot to do. And we get kids that are dying to take the class that find out it's not easy. And it is, in fact, scary sometimes. And it never mattered what challenge I gave Matt. I never got the traditional, that's my job today, nice eye roll that even my sixth grade daughter gives me. It was always, I got it, no problem, this one's taken care of. And every time he made steps with anyone I had him work with. Last story I want to share is just, I think, something that showed me in advance of what was going to happen this year. We take our students to Kankakee in June if they'd like to finish their certification. Kankakee. Tropics of the Midwest, blue, glazy water, palm trees, they're fake. And so Matt did that, and I did leave out the 58 degree water. So many kids will go with us and they'll get their certification and they'll realize I will never do this again. So come back to school in August and Matt's like, Mrs. Murphy, guess what I did this summer? And I'm like, you got to go on a trip? And he's like, oh, we went diving. And I'm like, where'd you go? Matt?
Pearl Lake.
That's South Beloit, Illinois, Wisconsin, right up there on the border. Not much different than Kankakee. It was so cool. They had this, and they had this, and they had this. I don't know. This is my 13th year teaching scuba. We've never had another student dive in the Midwest after they get certified. So Matt stands above and beyond. He took a group of friends. They organized on their own. And that's just kind of the student he is. I wish him the best of luck next year. So congratulations, Matt.
Thank you, Matt. I learned to scuba dive in Lake Champlain, which was not a whole lot better than Kankakee. That's going to conclude our ceremony this morning, but before we leave, I'd like to thank a few people. I'd like to thank Ms. Candy Faye. She's with LTTV. You'll notice over the next couple of weeks, there will be a broadcast of this morning's celebration with some footage from the students in the classrooms. I'd also like to thank my assistant, Ms. Karen Jakowiak. She really puts this together. I just kind of show up and get to enjoy it. Students, I'd like to congratulate you. You've set yourself apart from many others today. What I love about what I heard this morning is not one teacher said you have the highest grade in the class. It has nothing to do with why you're here. Some of you may have the highest grade in the class, but what we heard about today was kindness, working with others, empathy, compassion, and the things that really make LT such a special place. And certainly, but last but not least, I'd like to thank and congratulate the parents that are here this morning. Without your continual support, commitment, and guidance, we wouldn't have such fine students to recognize today. Thank you so much for coming out on this cold and windy day. Please feel free to have another cup of coffee. Students, if you need a late pass to first hour, you're welcome to stop by our office to get that, but have a wonderful day. Thank you.